Once again, from the headquarters of the McNeil International Film Studios, we're going to talk about how to read graphs. So, we have here this U-shaped graph. What could it be, disinterested econ student? I'm sure you said average cost. What's this other one, this lower U-shaped one? Average variable cost. I'm trying to make this as lifelike as I can. And this little curve right here that catches each of them at their bottom, that one. And when it's when the average is decreasing, this curve is below it. When the average is increasing, this curve is above it. And when the average is neither increasing nor decreasing, they're equal. What is this? Which graph is it?
Oh.
Marginal cost, of course. Now, what about this one? Oh, what's on the axis? Dollars here. And on the horizontal axis? Quantity produced. What's this graph? Whoa, like that. Starts at the origin, has that squiggly shape. What do we call this graph? I believe it's total variable cost. How do you know it's total variable cost? Because it starts at the origin. Why does it have that squiggly shape? Because of the law of diminishing returns. Good job. I knew you were about to mumble it. And now this one. Oh, can I do it? Not very well. This one is total cost. How do you know it's total cost? Because it starts above zero here. So, what would be total fixed cost here? And the answer is whatever is this value. Because when there are zero units produced and there are costs, those have to be fixed costs. They cannot be variable costs. And could we draw the total fixed cost? Yep, it's horizontal at whatever the level of fixed cost is. And on the horizontal axis we have quantity produced. On the vertical axis we have, dollars.
I believe you have a parrot.
Don't want to harm the parrot there. Okay. Now, see this? Bumpity, 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 bump. 15 units, there's a point, and there is a point. Now, when you think of these graphs, they are not lines. They are collections of points, and each point represents a combination of numbers that associates whatever is on the horizontal axis, quantity produced, to whatever is on the vertical axis, dollars. So in this case, it says, if you produce 15 units, your average variable cost will be about $15. That's average variable cost when you produce 15 units. If you produce a different quantity, then you would get a different cost figure. Okay, as we go up there, that point says that if you produce 15 units, then your average total cost will be $20 a unit. And this one says, ooh, look at that, $35. What does that mean? That says the 15th unit cost $35. $35 was the cost of your decision to produce the 15th unit specifically. This cost, $20, is the average cost of producing each of the 15 units. Some cost more, some cost less, but the average was 20. Now, do you know what is the average fixed cost? Yes, because average cost equals average fixed cost plus average variable cost. So if you know the average cost is 20 and the average variable cost is 15, then the average fixed cost must be 5. And it turns out by some amazing accident here that this gap between these two points is $5. So this $5 represents average fixed cost when you produce 15 units. Now, let's go over to this graph. This is the same quantity axis. And we'll find 15 here. There's 15. Perfect. Now let's go up. Oh, look at that, look at that, and look at that. What does this curve tell you? This point on this total variable cost curve says that if you produce 15 units, your total variable cost will be that amount. And your total cost will be that amount. And the difference between the two will be your total fixed cost. Because total cost equals total fixed cost plus total variable cost. Good. Take a breath. Thank you. Now, If you produce 15 units, and each of these units is costing you $20 on average, well, the average cost of producing 15 units is total cost of producing 15 divided by the quantity, which you know to be 15. And it turns out that you have two of these numbers, two out of the three. The quantity is 15. The average cost of producing each of these 15 units is $20. So can you use this information to find out what is total cost? And the answer is yes. Total cost is 15 units times $20 each unit on average. That's $300. Now, what is the size of this rectangle right here? And the answer is it's $20 high and 15 units wide. This represents total cost. And the total cost is, $300. So this point on the total cost curve says that when you produce 15 units, the total cost will be $300. What does this point tell you? It says that when you produce 15 units, your average variable cost is going to be $15. So this area, this rectangle here, is 15 units wide by 15 units high. And that represents the total variable cost of producing 15 units. And that number, 15 times 15, will be that amount. I'm not quick enough at the moment to figure out what is 15 times 15. Do you know a student there? 15 times 15.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. Well, anyway. And the difference between the two will be the total fixed cost. Now, the last beautiful one is this. If you know that the marginal cost of the 35th unit is, I'm sorry, of the 15th unit is $35 here, then can you tell me what is the total cost when you produce 14 units? And the answer is, you want to think about it for a second? The answer is $265. This one, $265. How do I know? Because your total cost went up by $35 when you produced the 15th unit, which means the 14th unit had to have cost you $35 less than this one. Anyway, it's just a little exercise in how to read these graphs, and that they're all connected, and it is, in some very twisted way, beautiful.